Summer of Threeee, the series or event on my channel where every video from here past SummerSlam will be SummerSlam related. I've explained it in the last video. If you missed, what was it? Roasting SummerSlam attires. That's day one of Summer of Threeee, but day two, I asked you guys over on Twitter like a couple days ago, what are some of your unpopular SummerSlam opinions? Now, we normally start off these events with videos like this one, with opinions, but I had to switch it up. I had to switch it up. And you guys delivered. Like, I've read through the opinions, and no one this year didn't say anything fucking stupid like this guy.
Twitter, what are some of your unpopular Royal Rumble opinions? You know about WWE's, the Royal Rumble. The road to WrestleMania starts here. The Royal Rumble pay-per-view event that happens every January. Yet somehow, some way, someone tweeted me, mixed corn with mashed potatoes is the best thing. Changed my mind. What does that have to do with the Royal Rumble? That's not the, oh my God. Unpopular Royal Rumble opinion, not unpopular food opinions. Am I Chef Ramsay? Am I a food channel? No! I don't give a fuck about your corn and mashed potato!
So we're gonna start off the video with Astro says, Wine Up by Cat DeLuna still holds the best theme for SummerSlam. Nah, I don't think you're correct, sir.
12 seconds later.
Could be top three. This one's on me. Ibrahim, or Expert Fighter, says Brock Lesnar has had the best SummerSlam matches out of anyone ever. Now, that's true. I honestly agree with this because Brock Lesnar shows the fuck out whenever it's SummerSlam. Every year, SummerSlam is Brock's fucking pay-per-view. Like, when you look at pay-per-views synonymous with names in the business, like you have like WrestleMania, Shawn Michaels, or Undertaker. You have Royal Rumble. And I didn't think I'd get this far in this conversation. But with SummerSlam, I think of Brock Lesnar. Every year, I think of, like, Brock Lesnar is that dude to build SummerSlam around. And he also says, Punk versus Hardy TLC at SummerSlam 09 was probably top three best one-on-one TLC matches ever. Honestly? Okay. Ibrahim is 2 for 2 right now, because that match banged. And for some reason, before I knew what dirt sheets were, or before I knew, like, you know, spoilers on the internet, I, for some reason, told my dad, we were watching, I was like, yo, I have a feeling Undertaker's about to show up. I don't know why. I don't know. He's like, you're crazy. You're tripping. And then at the end of the match, fucking Undertaker showed up, and my mind was fucking blown. To the day, I don't know how I did it. Jared changed his Twitter name from the 404. What a guy. I didn't know he changed it. But he says, I need Roman to wear all white so I can call him Cocaine Reigns, similar to Rollins at SummerSlam 2015. Now, although a all-white Roman fit would be clean, that joke,
that shit is fucking trash, dog. Get the fuck off the airwaves.
Monty's Corner. I haven't talked to Monty in fucking forever. Rip him. It's been a while. But Monty Corner said Orton should have went over on Lesnar. No. I enjoyed the match perfectly the way it was. Just, you know, Randy Orton talking shit about his steroids. Brock Lesnar was like, you know what? Alright. Pulls up. Beat his ass. Crack that motherfucking egg open. Now, the reason why I like that, because I wasn't expecting Mance to just knock his shit back and he'd start bleeding all over the ring. It's not often we get, you know, blood in matches lately, but that shit was wild and it was the hard way. It wasn't no blade job. Rice to Ryan says SummerSlam 2012 theme was the best one. I have very little faith because you said 2012. And that year in general was just ass. SummerSlam 2012, that shit was not the best in SummerSlam history. I can give you here, I'm not gonna confirm that this could be the best, but Now that's a fucking banger. Once again, two videos in a row, the second member of the YouTube Prophets, Muscle Man Malcolm, says Jon Stewart should have been added to the Cena versus Rollins 2015 match. Jake says, I'm about to get clowned, but Brock should beat Seth this year. Honestly, I don't see why you get clowned for that. Seth does not need this win. Like, honestly, have Brock retain. Or add Corbin to the match, and Corbin wins the title. I would be okay with that, but Seth Rollins is Universal Champion. Ketchup, KMBK Ketchup. So Ketchup says, I'ma say it. There are bigger parties in the summer. Miguel, or one charming man. But before we, let's see if you are a charming man. Okay, Miguel, you are a charming young man. This charming young man says Shinsuke should main event like he did for Wrestle Kingdom. Nerd! Thyler's Class says Randy Orton versus Brock Lesnar had the potential to be one of the best WWE SummerSlam matches of all time, but WWE booking messed it up. No, it didn't. It didn't even have the potential to be the best match of all time. It was a banger, but like, the booking didn't mess it up. It made perfect sense. You have the Beast incarnate. The fucking Beast whooped the shit out of Randy Orton. What did you think? How did you think that match was gonna go? How do you think any other Brock match go? Like when you see Brock on the card, how do you think that match is gonna go? Because you wanted like a 30 to 40 minute banger and fucking storytelling and all these falsies and shit like that. You want like a Gargano Adam Cole match out of Brock Lesnar and Randy. If you don't take this 10 to 15 minute ass whooping. Well, that's all the time I have this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please remember to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, comment down below your thoughts on this video and some unpopular SummerSlam opinions you have. I will see you guys for day 3 of Summer 3. I will be updating the playlist now because there's more than one video in the Summer 3. So if you want to go back and watch the last video, do that. That's cool. Watch my other videos, follow me on Twitter, boom. That's pretty much it.
Scrolling through Pornhub, I'm on page 4, cause I nut quick as fuck to these big booty whores. Got my PP in my hand, gotta watch the fucking door, cause if someone try to come in, then I ain't coming no